This tutorial is designed to get you started with ZePrA Smart Color Server. ZePrA is one of the three ColorLogic tools for color management workflow and can also integrate into an existing workflow for immediate results. The software is a must-have for all high-quality color management. Let's get started. After you installed ZePrA and loaded your license, we are going to do a basic use case. We are using ZePrA 9, but this basic information should be good for all versions of ZePrA. When you first start ZePrA, this will be your home screen. The Jobs and Queues overview shows only one drag and drop dummy queue. To create your first configuration for converting images and PDF files, click on the Home button to reveal a sidebar and click on Auto Setup, which opens the Automatic Setup Wizard dialog. As you can see, there are 7 options for the most typical use cases to get started. For this example, we are going to convert PDF and image files that have been prepared for offset printing on coated paper and that will finally be printed for newspaper. Select the first use case called Normalize and Convert Colors to New Apple Condition and click Continue. Select the first option if you have an existing device link profile, or select the second option, Use Smart Link, which creates device links on the fly, and click Continue. For the source color space, also known as a document color space in ZePrA, select the ISO-coded V2 ECI ICC profile. You can either use the drop-down menu or type in the name. For the target color space, we will need the WANIFRA newspaper profile. Again, you can either use the drop-down or you can type it in. There are several advanced ColorLogic rendering intents to select from. Details about what they are used for can be found in the online help by clicking on the question mark icon. This launches the online help in a browser where you will find all features explained in further detail. In our example, we are using the ColorLogic rendering intent standard compression, which is selected by default. In the next setting, select the Smart Link method. This defines how the device link will work in ZePrA and build on the fly for the conversion. There are several options here, and again, the online help will be your friend to explain which settings is suitable. We will be using the traditional printing classic method here, which is again selected by default, and click Continue. The next dialog of the wizard appears, allowing to define the queue name and the base folder. The base folder is a place where all the queues and their subfolders will be set up in. When clicking OK, the configuration with all the required color management settings and the queue and all required subfolders will be created automatically, and the auto setup wizard will close. If you do not have special needs such as converting spot colors to process colors or to use PDF flattening or other things, this queue is ready to be used. Now that your first configuration has been set up, you can now process files with it. This is one of the many great functionalities of ZePrA that, with the help of the Auto Setup Wizard, makes it fast and easy to create. To process files, simply right-click on the queue, and if you wish to convert only one file, click on Add File to Queue, or if you wish to convert multiple files, click on Open Folder. When you click on Open Folder, ZePrA opens the input subfolder of the queue, and now you would drop your batch of files into the folder. ZePrA will automatically recognize those files and begin to convert them. You can see the files appear in the overview with the progress information in the pending jobs section, and the converted files will show in the process jobs section. Converted files will be placed in the output folder, and they typically will have the name of the configuration and the ID number added to the file name. Those files are properly converted to the newspaper color space and can be printed faithfully on a newspaper press. The original files will be moved to the Done folder. Now, what happens to a file that ZePrA does not support, such as a PNG file? Well, ZePrA will place a file in the Error folder. So, for example, when I place a PNG file in the Input folder, ZePrA displays a format error message and will not convert it. And as you can see, it places that image file into the air folder. How do we edit a configuration in Queue? To demonstrate, I will change the configuration and apply flattening, and we are going to change the appended file name as well. To change the configuration, either right-click on the queue and select Edit Configuration, or simply double-click the queue. The Define Configuration dialog appears, which allows you to define various color management specific settings. Again, the online help is your friend to understand what can be done on each tab. In our example, we wish to apply transparency flattening, which can be found in the PDF tab. Click the checkbox to enable flattening. Click the settings button if you need a specific flattening setting. Once your configuration has changed, you can either click the Save button to apply the changes, or simply click the Home button and click Overview to go back to the Jobs and Queues Overview dialog. ZePrA recognizes that there are unsaved changes and reminds the user to save them. Click Yes to save your changes. Now to change a queue, right-click on the queue and select Edit Queue. The Define Queues dialog appears, and with the two tabs, for the selected queue, you may change the folders, or under Options, change other settings such as adding a report, adding a delay, or changing the priority for this queue over other queues. In our case, we wish to shorten the append text name, and we will shorten it to just simply newspaper. Click Save and the Home button and Overview, or even simpler, click the blue back button icon to get to the Overview dialog. And now you're ready to process your file. For more detailed information on ZePrA, use the online help or watch more tutorials on our YouTube channel for more advanced videos. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss a new release. Thanks for watching.